Welcome to Techzilla Bytes, feed your tech hunger fast. I'm Patrick Norton, and this morning Google dropped the needle on I.O. 2014, Google's annual Hey Developers and the Rest of the World. Here's what's coming from us. First big news is what's now. 1 billion active users per month, up from 538 million at last year's I.O. And while KitKat, that's the operating system, not the candy, is only on 15% of the Android devices in use right now, it's no big surprise that Google announced the next version of Android, the L version of Android at Google I.O. this morning. No cool sugary name yet. I guess licorice, lollipop, lemonhead, and lima bean weren't awesome enough, but Google says Android L will pack in 5,000 new APIs. Those are the little bits that let developers do a cool thing with the operating system. The Dalvik virtual machine going away. This is good in favor of ART, the Android runtime. That's the core of the operating system. Google claims ART will make Android run twice as fast, and it'll be all kinds of native on ARM, x86, and MIPS, offer better garbage collection, RAM management, and new graphics features for gamers. So, better gaming, better performance. I'm excited. This is a good thing. Developers with a Nexus 5 or 7 will be able to run L starting June 26th. I want it on my Moto G just to get notifications I can act on the lock screen. By the way, there's going to be new, easier ways to unlock your phone from trusted locations or Bluetooth devices. It all sounds really subtle and really convenient. One less password swipe is me getting the tunes playing and the map running in my car that much faster. It's a good thing. Something much less subtle, well, it is subtle from a design sense, but it's still in your face, is Google's material design. Quote, a new consistent design approach, unquote. Google's going in the opposite direction of Apple, it seems. Our material is grounded in tactile reality, inspired by our study of paper and ink, yet open to imagination and magic. Grad student art musing aside, it kind of sounds goofy, but it has the potential to finally deliver quality user interfaces across all Google's products. This promises to inform Google UI everywhere, Android phones and tablets, online at Gmail, Calendar, Google+, and I'd expect the two new Android platforms Google announced today. The first, Android TV for smart TV apps and navigation. The first hardware is going to come from Sony and Sharp, voice search to find live TV or Google Play movies and shows, and Android games reimagined for TV. That's a shot across the bow of Microsoft and the Xbox and pretty much everything else on the planet that connects to a television. And it sounds like they might be more open to working with non-Google Play sources of video, something Amazon's Fire TV has utterly miserably failed at. The second new platform, Android Auto. Google's goal is very simple here. Car and phone integrated seamlessly. Nats, right? Google worked with auto manufacturers and other partners to strip down and refine Android to kind of re-envision how Android will work. Google Maps made easier, touch targets, simplified interfaces. Quote, the idea of a conversational operating system with your car, like conversational OS. Well, the idea that you're going to talk to your car in a simple and managed way. You can set reminders while you're driving, for example, by talking at your car and not taking your hands off the wheel. This is all going to be about making Google Now more useful. I'm really curious to see if checking traffic and getting directions or just changing tunes is going to be as easy as Google has implied. This new operating system, the Android Auto, is going to hit this fall, and Android Auto-ready cars will be around at the end of this year. Google suggests you have a powerful handset since the screen in the car is really being casted by your phone. Hey, while we're talking cars, I love audiobooks on road trips, and you can get a free audiobook from our sponsor, audiblepodcast.com/techzilla. 150,000 titles to choose from New York Times bestsellers to, hey, if you haven't read them yet, A Game of Thrones and the rest of the Song of Fire and Ice series. Me, I'm getting ready to fire up Sherlock Holmes for the next road trip with the boys. The boys, by the way, will not be getting their hands on the new Android Wear devices, 1.6, 1.2. You can pre-order the Samsung Gear Live and LG G Watch today. Yes, get jellyfish warnings, estimates of commute times, music, say okay Google, and reply to text messages, track your calories, kill the Fitbit, ask Google questions, find out what song is playing. Google says, quote, most people check their phones more than 150 times a day, often to read a text, look at the notification, or get some other simple piece of information. That's a lot of time spent unlocking, swiping, and entering passwords when your hands could easily be free handling more important things, unquote. I like the concept, but we'll see how it goes. We're also really curious to see if the Moto 360 is as big as it looks when it arrives later this summer. Speaking of big, Android One. Quote, smartphones for under $100 available in India this fall, end quote. Android operating system, duh. The operating system will be updated by Google, not the local carriers. This is a good thing. Hardware reference platforms will be specced by Google to help manufacturers build low-cost phones for developing markets fast, or as Google put it, for the next billion. Google's thinking global, people. A little smaller, say your living room, Chromecast was mentioned. Later this year, Google's Wii Android-powered HDMI streaming stick will get Android mirroring. Finally, you'll be able to see what's on your phone or tablet on your TV. Backdrop, aka a customizable home screen, is coming, and people will be able to stream to your cast without having to be on your Wi-Fi network. That's kind of cool. Other tidbits dropped in the lengthy keynote include Project Volta, Google's efforts to improve battery life for all Android devices. The news that the Chrome OS is going to get the ability to run native Android applications eventually, and Drive for Work, aka unlimited storage on Google Drive for $10 a month, which is going to include enterprise-friendly controls and tools to help managers track employees' work. Huh. I don't know how I feel about being tracked, but I know I want you to like this video, and if you liked it, do us a favor, hit the button, like it, and share it with your friends. Hey, want to see our review of the new Moto G 4G LTE? Motorola's update to the awesome and affordable Moto G? I bought one, and I reviewed it, and please subscribe to get all of our Techzilla Bytes at techzilla.com or youtube.com/techzilla. Tweet at Techzilla. I am Patrick Norton. Thank you so much for watching.